हेलो एवरीवन, विशिंग यू अ वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर हेल्थी, हैप्पी एंड सेफ। गुड मॉर्निंग वाइनी, हाउ आर यू डूइंग? गुड मॉर्निंग संतोष, आई होप यू आर इन द बेस्ट ऑफ हेल्थ and enjoying life. Great, good news. Well, as I always begin my class, same instructions, keep your cameras off, because then you will be using a lot of, I'm fine Vaini, you'll be using a lot of data, which is not good. Good morning Deepak. Stay in a place where you get good network, as you will find video getting stuck. Good morning, Vishwant. And if you have to send any message, as you are doing right now, good morning, Karthik. Send it on the ID Aastik or on the ID, not ID, or send it to everyone so that I can interact with you. Good morning, Teja Beta. How are you? Chalo. That is all about introduction. I hope all of you join. Everyone is not available. Okay, not a problem. You can send it on my ID Aastik. I am fine, Jatul. Fine, fit, healthy, happy, safe, and wishing same to everyone. Okay. Good morning, Goli. Good to have you back. In previous class, we had understood the meaning of the term relative motion. And we have seen that relative motion means nothing but steady of a motion with respect to something else. Up till now, we were studying every motion with respect to Earth. But in the previous class, we have understood that sometimes studying the motion with respect to Earth may not be pretty simple. The motion may be very complicated with respect to Earth. But with respect to other reference frame, bus or train or wedge or prism, the motion may be pretty damn simple. So we have to use or understand the motion with respect to some other moving or stationary bodies. And that is what relative motion is. Relative motion is nothing, not a new topic. We have been doing it from day one, and we had seen the equations as well. We wrote the equation with respect to ground, and we wrote the equation with respect to other objects. So let us first quickly write the equation of motion with respect to other body. So I can write velocity of A with respect to B is equal to initial velocity of A with respect to B, good morning Sumant, plus acceleration of A with respect to B multiplied by T. That becomes my first equation. Number two, displacement of A with respect to B is initial velocity of A with respect to B into T, plus half acceleration of A with respect to B into T squared. Number three, V square of A with respect to B will be equal to U square of A with respect to B plus two times acceleration of A with respect to B into displacement of A with respect to B. Fourth equation, which would be hardly used, is the average velocity of A with respect to B will be equal to U of A with respect to B plus final velocity of A with respect to B divided by 2. Now all these equations are only valid for constant acceleration. Constant acceleration, acceleration must be constant and must be used with proper sign conventions. Proper sign conventions. Proper sign convention. And the sign convention is, what is the sign convention? Positive x-axis is positive, negative x-axis is negative if you talk about x-axis. If you talk about y-axis, upwards is positive, downwards is negative. Now, we will be seeing how will you find out these quantities. Now, again, we'll be studying it under two headings. Relative motion in one dimension, where everything will be moving only in a straight line, either along x-axis or along y-axis. And the more complicated one would be relative motion in two dimension, where, as we all know, they will move along x as well as it will move along y. Now, but before getting on to solving problems, we must first understand how will I get this A with respect to B. I have written velocity of A with respect to V. I have written displacement of A with respect to B. I have written acceleration of A with respect to B. The point is, how will I get it? How will I find this value? There are different ways of understanding it. I will try by the way that I know works always. Might look a bit complicated to start with. Let us say this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. So basically, when I'm trying to understand it, I'm starting with motion in two dimension. So that if you understand that, you can definitely understand what is, how relative velocity in one dimension will look, if you understand two dimension. This is my origin of coordinates. Now I have one body A here. Please pay all your attention on the whiteboard right now. You can write the notes afterwards. I always share the notes with you. Just try to understand what I'm saying here. This is the object, one object or one person, car, train, bus, is at point A. Now, how do I give its position? How do I show its position? I draw a vector. I draw a vector from O to A, and we call it position vector of A with respect to O. Yes or no? Do we remember this? Position vector of A with respect to O. A vector drawn from O to A. Vaini says yes. Can the others also, by raising hand, tell me that we remember this? Remember how to find the position of point A with respect to O. Draw a vector from O to A. We call it position vector of A with respect to O. I only have five raised hands. That will not be good enough. Vijay, Sanjay, Harsha, Rishika, Vijay, Triveni, Harshita, Pawan, Sai, Reddy, Rajesh, Veronica, Jasmine, Wake Up, Shashank, Dinesh, Likita, Karthik, Shashank, Jyotana, Jayashankar, Jagdish, Goli, Santosh, Charita, Shriya, Maruti. Are you all there? Are you all understand this? Okay. So this is my body here. Great, great. Yes, yes, and we are going to do that. Just give me some time. Give me some time. See, I have a very small brain. I'm an old person. My brain is deteriorating. Not like Hannah, not like Anjali, not like Shriya, not like you. Your brains are developing. My brain is deteriorating. So I need time to do it. Beta, I'm not super fast like you guys. Some time lag is there. I'm an old processor. I'm a Intel Pentium processor. Useless processor. You are i7, i8, i9. I can't compete with you guys. Give me time. I'll just see. Okay, so this is body A. I know its position. Now there is this body B. It could be the bus, it could be the bike, something is there. How do I find its position? How do I tell its position from the origin O? Very simple. I will draw a vector from O to B. So this will be known as position vector of what? B with respect to O. Do we understand this? Position vector of B with respect to O. We understand this. What do I do next? What do I do next? A very simple, a very elegant thing that I have done previously also, but I did it in some other respect. And I try to recollect that point as well. Now I'll draw a vector. Now I will draw a vector from where to where? From B to A. Yes, Hannah. I'm trying to catch up. You are on an i9 processor. I am an Intel Pentium Shuruaat wali generation. I'm trying to catch up. I'll draw a vector from B to A. Just finally. I know you are also on i10, i11, Pentium. B to A. What will I call this vector? What will I call this vector? Simple. Everyone knows it. What will I call it? What will I call it? What will I call this set vector? Everyone knows it. Position vector of A with respect to B. Do we all agree on this? This will be known as position vector of A with respect to B. Yes or no? Yes or no? Great. Great. Now, what can I do now? I'm thinking, what can I do now? Okay. Let us try to recollect what we did in the very first classes. Very first classes. This entire thing remind you of something. But the entire thing remind you of something. One vector going like this, one vector going like this, one vector going like this. You just draw it here. Triangle. Precisely what, Vahini? See, you are on an i9, i10 processor. I am Intel Pentium, Shuruaat wali generation. Triangle law of vectors. I'll try to recollect. Pentium processor lagging behind, trying to catch up. Pulling back off A with respect to B, position vector of B with respect to O, B and B will have this, B and B cancel, and we will have position vector of A with respect to O. Do we remember this, everyone? You remember it in a Shuruaat mein, the particle is here at point A, displacement. Displacement is a vector drawn from B to A, same thing, but in a different way. Do we all understand this? But I am doing the same thing. Previously, I was calling it displacement. Now, instead of displacement, I call it O. That's it. And I'm done. Now, I can take this. So, I get position vector of A with respect to B. Position vector of A with respect to B. To O minus the position vector of B with respect to O. Do we all agree on this? Do you all agree on this? Is it some all of a sudden? Or we have already done it before? We probably understood in a different way for a different term for displacement is relative velocity. So, Tija, we do not continue. We have already done. Just now seeing it in a different light. We are enlightened souls now. We are more enlightened than what we were in the beginning of our course. We are more enlightened. We are mature. We have grown by a month or a two, and every day you learn something new. Position vector of A with respect to B is with respect to O. Now, instead of writing it as O, I can very well write it as, cut this O, write it as G, where G becomes your ground. Yes or no? A with respect to body B, this body A could be anything. Train, bus, car, ball. Vector of A with respect to B would always be equal with respect to ground. Am I clear with this concept? You can also remember it in this way. You put a G in between. This is how I remember it. Put a G in between with respect to B. Put a G in between. It will be A with respect to G. position vector of A ground with respect to B, ground with respect to B can be written as position vector of A with respect to ground, and this entire thing becomes minus the opposite vector. In different ways I have tried to make you understand. Position vector of A with respect to B, you put a respect to B as negative of B with respect to ground. Can I have some raised hands? Now that we have understood this concept of how we are going to find the position vector of A with respect to B. A with respect to B will be position vector of A with respect to G minus position vector of B with respect to D. I only have 12 raised hands. That's not good enough. 15. Vijay Lakshmi, you never speak anything. Venkatesh, Sanjay, Harsh, Vardhan, Rishika, Triveni, Harshita, Surendra, Siddharth, Shivat Mika, Sana, Sai, Rajesh, Rahul, Veronica, Jasmine, Shashank, Dinesh, Nikita, you have not responded. Karthik, Kevin, I don't know where you, probably playing PUBG. That's what you are at DP says. Jyotsana, Jay Shankar, Jagdish, Charita, Maruti. Kevin, you can make a deal. If you can attend my class and be attentive, I will try to learn PUBG from you. I'm not a big fan of PUBG. But if you make a deal, you call it deal. So you be attentive in the class, come in the class, do the question, and I will take lessons from you on PUBG. And I probably will become a better player. Then we can have a match together on PUBG and let's see who wins. Position vector of A with respect to B is equal to position vector of A with respect to ground minus position vector of B with respect to ground. Now let us do simple things here. And with those simple things, so this is one way of writing this equation. Now what I'm going to do. Okay. Now I'm going to put a delta before this. And someone is going to tell me now what does this equation represent. So you can raise your hands while I'm writing the equation, and then I'll give someone a chance to speak up and tell me now what does this equation mean. Have you raised hands? 15 people have raised hands. So some of you will get a chance to speak. Vahini is the first name that I see. Vahini, can you unmute yourself? Tell me what is the meaning of equation number 2, Vahini. Vahini has disappeared. So next in line is, I've asked you to unmute. Can you unmute yourself and tell me what is equation number 2? Vahini has also disappeared. So whosoever I select, they disappear. Who is going to tell me what equation number 2 represent? Now raise your hands so that I can ask and I can give you an opportunity. Equation number 2 represent now. No one understands equation number 2? Hands. So Hanak will get a chance. Hanak, unmute yourself. Tell me what does equation number 2 mean?
Displacement of R vector from point A to B equals
wrong. It's not from point A to point B, wrong. Again, rephrase your question. Rephrase your answer. Try. Yashwant, you can also, I'm asking you to unmute. Help your friend Hanak. He is somewhat confused.
Position vector with respect to A to B equals to.
Ready. Not correct. Karthik, your chance. Two friends are in trouble. Help him. Help them. No, Karthik is not able to speak. Santosh, your chance. Help these guys. They're getting confused.
Change of displacement. Change of vector R with respect to A. A with respect to B equals to.
Is equal to
change of vector R A with respect to ground minus change of vector R.
Something I think you have missed, Santosh. Teja, Tetore beta, unmute yourself. Tell me what does this mean? I was not able to understand Deepak, Santosh correctly. Teja, can you help me out?
displacement of A relative with B equals to displacement of A with respect to the ground minus displacement of B with respect to the ground.
Well done, Deja. That is correct. This sign, let me all unmute yourself. Let me mute you all. Otherwise, I'll get a lot of disturbances. Muted you. Okay. So what does this mean? It's very simple. The first term means, this one. It means the displacement of A with respect to B. In fact, it means displacement vector of A with respect to B is equal to displacement vector of A with respect to G minus displacement vector of B with respect to G. Am I clear? Can I have raised hand that we understand this? Displacement vector of A with respect to B is equal to displacement vector of A with respect to G minus displacement vector of B with respect to G. Am I clear? I'll write this equation in a third way. If I divide or if I differentiate equation number one with respect to time, what will I get? 1 minute. Think about it. If I differentiate equation number one with respect to t, what will I get? Anyone with an answer? I'll lower all your hands first. Anyone knows an answer? Please raise your hands. We get first equation. I will differentiate Hanap equation number one with respect to time. What will I get? The first equation is position vector of A with respect to V. First equation of motion. No, not the first equation of motion. I will differentiate D R vector AB by DT will be equal to D by DT of R vector A with respect to ground minus D by DT of R vector B with respect to ground. This is how I differentiate. What do I get? Anyone, what do I get? Derivative of position vector with respect to time. Derivative of position vector with respect to time, what will you get? derivative of position vector with respect to time, what will you get? You will get velocity of something. Velocity of A with respect to B. This will give me velocity of A with respect to B. What will the second term give me? What will the second term give me? Velocity of A with respect to G. Well done, Santosh. What will the third term give me? What does the third term give me? Velocity of B with respect to G. And that is what I get by differentiating equation number one with time. Can I have some raise hand that we understand this? Raise hand that we understand this. What I have done is simply differentiated equation number one. Differentiated equation number one with respect to time. Differentiated equation number one with respect to time. When I get this. Am I clear? This hand will give me more confidence. Fourth. Now I'll differentiate. Let me call this as equation number three. Now I will differentiate equation number three with time t. Can I have the answers? I'll give you a minute. Differentiate equation number three with time. Can I have your answers? Acceleration. Tell me the equation, Hannah. What equation will I get? What equation will I get? I will differentiate equation number three with time. What will I get? Well done, Deepak. I will ask you to unmute. Where is Deepak? Deepak, unmute yourself and tell me what do you get?
Acceleration of A with respect to B.
Just a minute. I just missed the vector sign here. So I'll just put the vector sign here. Okay. Tell me, what do I get now?
Acceleration of A with respect to B.
Acceleration of A with respect to B.
Is equal to
acceleration of A.
Acceleration of A with respect to ground G minus acceleration of B with respect to G.
That's it. I will get this equation. Am I clear with everyone? Can I have some reason that we understand this? It's very simple, sir. Once you write the equation of vectors, everything looks very simple. In simple language. Simple language. Let me decorate. Let me write this equation together all. First one. Position vector of A with respect to B is position vector of A with respect to ground minus position vector of B with respect to ground. Displacement vector of A with respect to B will be equal to displacement vector of A with respect to ground minus displacement vector of B with respect to ground. Velocity vector of A with respect to B is velocity vector of A with respect to ground minus velocity vector of B with respect to ground. Acceleration of A with respect to B is equal to acceleration of A with respect to ground minus acceleration of B with respect to ground. Now, these are the equations. Now, if you don't want to use vector sign, if you don't want to use vector sign, what will you do? I don't want to use vector sign because as soon as vector sign comes, I start to get confused. So if I don't want to use vector sign, what will I do? I will use plus or minus. Plus or minus for vector. Yes or no? Do you understand this? Okay. What I'll do is, just a moment. I'll give you a question. And let's see who can solve this. Are we ready to solve a question? Are we all ready to solve a question? Just a moment. Okay. So here comes the question, and this question is taken from, just a minute, let me just go. Not this. Okay, so now let me give you a question and let's see who can do this for me. Anyone can see this question? Solve example number one. Anyone can see this question? Solve example number one. Yes or no? Example number one. See the figure. Take positive direction towards right. Towards right means aage, positive x-axis. Take negative towards left. Left. Find. You see three people. You see three people. A, B, and C. You need to find X, B, A. XCA, XCB, XAB, XAC. I don't know what does it mean. I'm working on an old processor. I hope your processor is newer and you can get me the answers. Give you a minute. Do it. Anyone with an answer? Deepak and Santosh have raised hands. I'll just ask them to lower their hands. Take the figure, positive x direction towards right. Position of, Santosh has given me some answers. I hope everyone has seen the question? What I'll do is, I will try to solve it on my own, and let's see whether our answer that you have given and answer that I get, whether they match or not. Let's try it. I think you can now see my whiteboard. Let me draw the question, question number one. I will draw it in the simplest possible way. This is the platter. Here I have got one person, here I have got another person, and here I have got the third person. This is A, this is B, this is C. This is 4 meters, and this is 6 meters. 6 meters, okay. This is my origin, doesn't matter what where origin is. Now, what are we supposed to find out? Number one, XBA. What do you mean by XBA? First of all, tell me the meaning of this. XBA, what do you mean by XBA? Who will tell me the meaning of this first? XBA. Raise your hands, tell me the answer. What does XBA mean? Yes, Goli. Goli has raised his hand. Goli, unmute yourself. Tell me the meaning of XBA.
Position of X of B with respect to A.
Position in terms of X, because this is on X axis. X position of B with respect to A. Do you know the answer, Goli? What is the answer?
Plus
4 meters. So where is B when seen from A? A is here. B is here. So I have to draw a vector from A to B. Position vector of B with respect to A. So it will be position vector of B. So X of B. I will not write the vector. X of B with respect to origin. Let me call this as origin. Minus X of A with respect to origin. Now it's pretty simple. Position of X B with respect to origin is plus 4, and this is the origin, so the answer is plus 4 meters. Do we understand this position of B with respect to A? It's in terms of X coordinate, therefore it is written X. Can I have some raise hand that we have understood this? Great, good one. Let's see who can give me the answer to the next one. XCA. Who knows the answer? Please raise hands and load all your hands. XCA, who knows the answer? The first one is Santosh. Santosh, give me the answer.
The position vector of person C with respect to person A.
So it will be position vector of C with respect to A. How will I find it out, Santosh?
Plus 10 meters.
So it will be C with respect to O minus position vector of A with respect to O in terms of plus and minus. Position vector of C with respect to O, as Santosh said, is plus 10, origin is here, this is here, plus 10 minus 0. So the answer is plus 10 meters. Do you all agree with Santosh? Santosh, well done. You have done it correctly. Well done, Santosh. Everyone got the answer? Great. Comes up with the third one. Let me all lower all your hands and let me see who gets the hand up first. X of CB. Who knows the answer for this? X of CB. Please raise your hands. Manasa has raised her hand. So Manasa, your chance. Tell me the answer.
Position vector of C with respect to B.
How will I find it out, Manasa? So you have to tell me also how to find out. So position vector of C with respect to O.
With respect to O minus position vector of B with respect to O.
Okay, very good. What is the position vector of C with respect to O?
Plus
10. Minus, what is the position vector of B with respect to O? Plus 4. Plus is important. It's a vector. Plus indicates its direction. So the final answer is plus 6 meters. Plus 6 is important, Manasa. If you don't say plus, what will you miss? You will miss the direction. You miss the direction, you have killed the vector. Don't kill vectors. We are not killers. We are learners. We don't kill. We learn. Next one is this one. Let me see who raises his hand first. Where is the question? I forgot the question. XAB. Who has raised the answer? Who has raised the hand? Teja has raised his hand. So Teja gets a chance to answer it. Yes, beta.
Position vector of A with respect to O minus position vector of. Okay, sir.
See, I am on Pentium first generation. I am slow. So XAB means position vector of A with respect to B. How will I calculate it, Teja?
Position X A with respect to O minus position vector of B with respect to O.
That's great. What is the position vector of A with respect to O? This is 0. Minus, what is the position vector of B with respect to O?
Plus 4.
So the final answer is minus 4 meters. Do we understand this, everyone? Can I have some raise hand that we have understood this, sir? No problems with this one. This is pretty damn simple. Pretty damn simple. That takes us to the last question in this category. XAC. Let me see who has raised. Let me lower our hands first. Let me see. Sainath. Without even saying, Sainath has raised his hand. So Sainath has disappeared. Who else? Who can solve this question? A with respect to C. Raise hand. Vahini. Okay, I'll give Vahini a chance. Please raise hand so that it becomes easier for me to. Deepak has got his chance. Deepak is not ready to talk. Karthik will get his chance then. Karthik.
Sir, position vector of A with respect to C.
How will I find it?
Position vector of A minus position vector of C with respect to O.
Great. A with minus C with respect to O is how much? Karthik. Deepak. Plus 10. So my final answer is minus 10 meters. Do you have understood this question? Please raise your hands now. I will again repeat what we have done. We had this B with respect to A. It's B with respect to O minus A with respect to O. Don't worry, Karthik, nothing, no problem. So we got the first answer as plus 4. Position vector of C with respect to A. We got the answer as plus 10. Position vector of C with respect to B. We got the answer as plus 6. Position vector of A with respect to B. We got the answer as minus 4. Position vector of A with respect to C, we got the answer as minus 10. Those who have not understood, please raise your hands. I'll help you out. I hope everyone has got this. Then comes the next one. We are done with position vector. So the next thing will haunt us. And the next thing is this thing that is on your board right now. Solve example number 2. Example number 2. An object A is moving with 5 meter per second and B is moving with 20 meter per second in the same direction, which is positive x-axis. And these are the questions that you have to solve. I hope I'll give you a minute, 2 minutes. Take a minute. Solve the question. Get your answers. Then I will ask you how you have done this. Read the question carefully, solve it, get your answers. Velocity of B with respect to A is plus 15. Velocity of A with respect to B is minus 15. Everyone got this? Okay. Great. First, let me. I hope everyone has seen the question. Okay. Question number two, and here is question number two. A is moving with 5 meters per second. So this is velocity of A with respect to ground. It's 5 meters per second like this. So I'll call it plus 5 meters per second. I hope you understand the meaning of plus forward, right? Then I have this one, velocity of B with respect to ground. Plus 20 meters per second. I hope you have drawn the diagram. What is asked? Number one, velocity of B with respect to A. Let me see who has solved this question. If you are able to solve this question, please raise hands. I'll give you a chance to solve it on board. Let's see who has raised his hand. Santosh has raised his hand first. Santosh, here is your chance. Tell me how to do it.
Velocity of B with respect to A equals to velocity of B minus velocity of A.
Velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of?
Velocity of A with respect to ground.
Great. What is the velocity of B with respect to ground?
Plus 20 meters per second.
Yes, plus 20. So plus 20. Minus, what is the velocity of A with respect to ground? Plus
5 meters per second.
Plus 5. I am not adding the units. So my answer is plus 15 meters per second. This is the velocity of B with respect to A. I hope all of you got this. The next one is velocity of A with respect to B. Who is going to tell me the answer for this one? Raise hand, please. Let me see who has raised hand. Santosh has raised hand. Santosh has given answer right now. So I'll ask someone else. Teja has raised hand. Apart from Santosh and Teja, Santosh and Teja have given quite a few answers today. So I would like someone else to raise hands who can solve this question. Anyone apart from Santosh and Teja? Who can solve this question? No one. Anil, Satya, Venu, Shriya, Kartik. Okay, I got someone. Goli. Okay, Goli, I'll give you a chance. Goli, tell me how to solve it.
Velocity of A with respect to G minus velocity of B with respect to G.
Minus velocity of B with respect to G. Tell me the values.
Equal to plus 5 minus plus 20.
Well done. Goli, what is the answer? 50. Is equal to minus 15 meter per second. Velocity of A with respect to B. Now, instead of doing this, Goli, you know the velocity of B with respect to A is plus 15. From here also, you could have given the answer. If velocity of B with respect to A is plus 15, what would be the velocity of ulta? Ulta means velocity of A with respect to B. It has to be the negative. Yes, Teja, you can accept. A with B is negative of velocity of B. But design that we understand this, sir. No problems with this one. This is pretty damn simple. Only 6 people have understood this. Only 9. Not good. Shashank, Manasa, Harsh, Vijay, Trivini, Harshita, Siddharth, Sai, Sarda, Sana, Reddy, Rakistik, Kevin, Josa, Jagdia, Sai Tarun, Shriya, Venu, Maruti, are you all there, Anil? Okay. Here comes the next one for you. Probably the last one for today's class. So I hope all of you can get me this one, and this is example number 3. Example number 3, I think this is what we have for today. Example number 3, two objects A and B are moving towards each other with velocities 10 meter and 12 meter per second respectively. Fine, something. Read the question. You can always take forward direction as positive and reverse as negative. That is what we always use. You solve the question, get me the answer. Anak is there with an answer. Teja is there with an answer. Well, let us solve this question. I hope all of you are getting answers. Well done, Santosh. Answers are coming at a rapid pace. Good, Jayashankar. Welcome to the class. Good that you are participating here. Well done, Jeja. Question number 3, I think. We'll draw a simple diagram. This is A. A is moving like this. Velocity of A with respect to ground is plus 10, according to my convention. B is coming from here. Velocity of B with respect to ground is minus 12. Meter per second, according to my convention. And now I'm asking the question, answer. The first one is velocity of A with respect to B. Let me see who is going to give me the answer for this one. Deepak is the new one. So Deepak, tell me how to do it.
Velocity of A with respect to B is equal to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground is equal to 10 plus 10 minus of minus 12 is equal to plus 22 meters per second.
Well done, Deepak. That is the answer for velocity of A with respect to B. So how does ACB come in? Velocity of A with respect to B. That means if you are in B, how do you see A coming? A seems to be very fast, 22 meter per second, very fast. You might have experienced this when are you sitting in a train and two opposite trains are crossing each other. You'll always feel the other train is moving faster. Have you felt it? That the other train is moving very fast and your train is very slow. Have you felt it? Please raise your hand if you have felt it. Sitting in a train, you watch the other train and you always feel that the other train is always faster. Yeah, why is my train always slower? Yes, Teja. Let us assume that Goli is sitting in this train. Goli is sitting in this train. Goli has given me answer, and Deepak is sitting in this train. So what we have found out is what Goli sees, the train of Deepak is moving. And Goli sees that Deepak's train is moving at 22 meter per second, very fast. very fast. Now let us see the opposite of it. What does Deepak see? How ball is moving? Velocity of B with respect to A. Who will give me the answer for velocity of B with respect to A? Who will give me the answer for this one? Raise hands. Teja, Deepak, you have given the answers. I am waiting for someone new. Goli, you have also given answer. Santosh, okay, Santosh, I'll give you a chance. Santosh, tell me, what is the velocity of B with respect to A?
Velocity of B with respect to A equals to minus velocity of A with respect
velocity to B. Velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of
A with respect to G.
A with respect to ground, minus 12, minus plus 10. So the answer will be minus 22 meter per second. You did not have to do this. You could have straight away written it. From where? If the velocity of A with respect to B is plus, velocity of B with respect to A would be plus of that same thing. So now we can see what Deepak will see goalie's train moving with. We'll also see goalie's train moving with faster moving with 22 meter per second in the reverse direction. Both see the same thing. Our train is always slower. The other train is always faster when we are moving in the opposite direction. That is what relative velocity is all about. I hope you have enjoyed this class. As homework, what will I do is, there is turn number 4, example number 4 and example number 5. I share it with you right now. So please solution as example given in your notes. Example number 4, example number 5, example number 6, example number 7, 4, 5, and answer in the group. I'll be very pleased if you can put your answer in the group for relative velocity. Until then, stay healthy and stay happy. Bye-bye.